hard. Anyway, you gotta be very careful because of the hand wire. back. That's how they end up stopping it up. So I like to just do one. These are acid for a filter dryer. There's no acid in the system though. We took the oil to the analysis place and they didn't find anything. This has been too. lighten them up. And when I get ready to put my nitrogen to leak check, I just put soap bubbles all around this area here, make sure it's sealed tight. I don't have any leaks. I'm thinking about, because I got rust seat this and shut it, close the valve right here. So I'm thinking about installing, every time I open them up, installing a valve maybe down here after the filter dryer. So we won't have to pump down the unit or cover out a refrigerant whenever we think that the filter dryer is stopped up. So, like I say, I think I just might go ahead and do that. I didn't want to, but it seems like I don't have the time, but the compressor needs to be filled, so I have time. So I'm gonna go over there and troubleshoot that EHP valve and make sure I got voltage going through it from 0 to 100% when it opens and closes. So I'm suspecting that valve is definitely some problem. So, all right, that's what we got. I changed my filter dryer. Clean it up a little bit and move on to the next task. We out.